Crawford. Two game sevens, one win, one defeat, three goals against. Jonathan Quick in game seven. 3-0, only four goals allowed.
Daryl Sutter, the head coach of the LA Kings, he said this morning with a smile on his face, these game sevens are fun. He played and coached in many of these. And meanwhile, Joel Quenneville, as he said this morning, we need to keep playing fast, faster each game. He wants to be even faster this game than they were in game six.
It is the seventh game seven of these playoffs, which ties an NHL record, the first in a West Final since Detroit and Colorado in 2002. Kopitar and Taves, their 77th faceoff of this series. Kopitar 39 wins, Taves 38. That's how close it has been. Puck deflects off the stick of Marion Gaborik. Top lines matched up against one another. Nicholas Jalmerson clears the puck out. Same lineup for Los Angeles. One change for the Blackhawks. Christopher Steed scratched in game six. Back in for Sheldon Brookbank.
Marion Gaborik almost had a partial break from the blue line in, reminiscent from a goal he scored about 7 seconds in early on in these playoffs. The Chicago Blackhawks got all lopsided on one side. Duncan Keith came over to help Jalmerson. Look how much room Gaborik had on that side. He just couldn't quite control the puck at the last seven. Last second, Chicago really dodges a bullet there.
Keith moves the puck. Held it at the point by Mitchell. Early saved by Crawford. Kings have Carter, Toffoli, and Pearson on the ice. Tremendous early in the series. Carter's shot gets blocked. Moves the puck into the corner. Jalmerson and Toffoli. And now it's deflected out by Patrick Sharp.
And I think this is the line for LA that has to have a big game. 15 points in the first three games, just five in the last three.
Agreed.
Long shot by Odia, kicked out by Jonathan Quick. Puck worked around by Jared Stoll. Andrew Shaw in on the forecheck. And Tanner Pearson clears the puck out. Early first period in Chicago, game seven. Kings had a 3-1 lead, thanks in large part to number 88 of the Blackhawks, Patrick Kane. Chicago has won the last two after trailing in the third period in both game five and game six.
Oh, did King ever get a piece of Oduya there along the board? That was a solid hit.
Kane keeps the puck in the zone for the Blackhawks. Pass across is kept away from Saad by Jared Stoll. Kings move out of their own zone, skating left to right. Jake Buzzet into the Blackhawks' end for Justin Williams. Puck loose in front, and it's knocked out of trouble by Michael Rosenvall. Rosenvall with Hanzus. Hanzus, the overtime hero in game five. Sticked aside by Quick and played by Mike Richards, who has won all six of the seven games he has participated in throughout his playoff career.
Yeah, he hasn't been real noticeable in this series, not getting the kind of ice time that he's had in the past. As Brian was saying this morning, watch out for Mike Richards.
In the two game seven so far, I thought he was the best player on the ice in their first game seven, and he was right there in the top three in the next couple. So I agree, Mike Richards is the guy you have to keep your eye on and see where he's going to be at. Meanwhile, Dwight King set the tone here with some physical play along the boards. He really took out Johnny Oduya. Johnny Oduya has been a key guy for Chicago throughout these playoffs, and for me, particularly in this series, he's probably been the most aggressive. And then Jared Stoll, right side of your screen, right there with a terrific back check.
The top line's matched up once again. Puck deflected ahead by Gaborik. And now waiting is Dustin Brown with Gaborik in the zone.
Jonathan Toews got the better of Kopitar in game number six in all aspects. Kopitar had a tough game in the faceoff circle. That's something that normally doesn't happen. But it's just to watch these two great players go at one another in a clean, hard fashion for six games has really been something special. Two of the best players in the game, two big-time players. Kopitar looking for his first goal of the series.
He leads the NHL with 23 points throughout this postseason. He has four assists in this series, but as Joe mentioned, no goals. Duncan Keith fans on the shot. Keeps the puck alive for Jonathan Toews. Taves dropping it off for Hossa. His shot was blocked. Marion Hossa, without a goal in this series as well, has not scored in 11 games. Now Dustin Brown, the Kings captain. Marion Gaborik checks towards the net. Wide to the left of Crawford. Jalmerson plays it for the Blackhawks as both teams look to make changes. Just over 3 minutes gone. Blackhawks have two shots, Kings with one.
Brian was talking about keeping an eye on Mike Richards. I think you have to keep an eye on Hossa, who leads this team in shots in this series.
That leads the entire league in shots throughout the Stanley Cup playoffs. Puck cleared ahead by Seabrook. Knocked back in by Jeff Carter. And now it is Brent Seabrook once again for Chicago. Game 7, no score, early first period. Puck blocked off by Toffoli.
Offside!
The lead offside, and now the Blackhawks look to move it back up ice. Johnny Oduya. Justin Williams. Blackhawks in the midst of a change. Drew Dowdy for Williams. Now Jake Muzzin, who has a couple of big goals in this series. White King sends in deep for Jarrett Stoll. Around behind for Williams. Puck comes out in front, but Williams had it knocked away, and King controls for the Blackhawks. Now Brandon Saad. Michael Rosenvall. Blackhawks stay onside. Puck comes around, Saad and Williams come together. Nick Leddy moves it in deep. Muzzin took it away from Kane. Clifford hit by Rosenvall. And now it is Kane, knocked away by Muzzin and forced out by Clifford. Quickly back in is Saad. Dropping it off for Andrew Shaw. Now Saad looking for Kane. It comes to Keith, but he fires wide. And then the puck bounces over the stick of Shaw. Now it is Kane to the far side. Score from a tough angle. Brandon Saad, 1-0 Chicago.
The speed, the aggressiveness of this line, the defense getting involved, and eventually that shot from a bad angle. But it was the Hawks that came hard on the forecheck. And that beautiful pass from Patrick Kane to the other side.
That's why this line works so well. Shaw, the aggressive guy, turns the puck over. The terrific hands of both Kane and Saad. Look at Kane. He looks into the front, fakes out a couple of LA Kings. Saad, the left-hand shot on the right-hand side. It gives him an angle to the net. He scores from nearly impossible.
He pounded his stick on the ice to get the attention of Patrick Kane, who looked up, saw him, and made the pass.
Fourth goal of the series for 21-year-old Brandon Saad. The Blackhawks strike first for the fifth time in this series. Now Brian Bickle with the puck into the corner for Taves, and now Hossa. Hossa tied up by Voinov, chips it ahead, knocked down by Keith, met by Brown, and now it is Bickle. Bickle out to the slot for Keith. Got a save by Quick with the right pad.
Keith again is very aggressive to start this game as he was in game 6.
And that has been a key for the Blackhawks over the last 2 games. The aggressiveness of their defensemen. Taves battling with Kopitar. Bickle with a shot, and that gets blocked by Mitchell. Sent to the far side by Voinov. Seabrook moves in. Seabrook shoots from a tough angle. Is saved by Quick. Puck held in by Keith. Keith's shot deflected just wide. And Smith getting a piece of it. This is Smith. Looks to cut out in front around Voinov, and Quick will smother. Standing ovation for the Blackhawks following the early goal scored by Brandon Saad.
Goal scorer Brandon Saad on the right, Patrick Kane, the assist man on the left. The line that was put together, it took about 4 games into the series to find a second line for the Chicago Blackhawks. And look at the numbers they have put up in the last 3 games. That's been the biggest difference in the turnaround for Chicago. You had the Taves line, and then it was going to be who else? Who was Kane going to play with? Who was Sharp going to play with? Where was it going to be the defense that were going to get points? No, it was the Shaw line, but it took 4 games to get there.
Brian, at least 2 members of that line, and in most cases, all 3, have been on the ice now for 9 of the last 10 Chicago Blackhawks goals. shot from Kane and Shaw at 5:06. Gotta go through you with a shot. Wide for the left to Jonathan Quick. Kept in his own by the Blackhawks. This is Marcus Kruger. Kruger hit by Muzzin. Pearson comes away with the puck. Tanner Pearson, who has scored in both previous game sevens for the Kings this season. Now Jeff Carter. Carter sends one across for Muzzin, and his shot gets blocked in front. Seabrook got it for Chicago. And now Patrick Sharp will send it across for Johnny Oduya.
Muzzin had a great look there. That hit Seabrook in front.
Now Muzzin up the left side. King couldn't play it. Comes out of the zone to Rosenbaum. Now Andrew Shaw. Shaw, Saad, Kane back on the ice for the Blackhawks. Drew Doughty watched by the forechecking Patrick Kane across to Willie Mitchell. 7.5 in, first period. Shots are 4-1. Blackhawks, Jared Stoll. His centering pass blocked off, intended for King. Rosenbaum tied him up. Now King on the puck. Hit by Rosenbaum. Around behind for Stoll. Bounces over his stick. Now Justin Williams. Hooked a bit by Shaw. Rosenbaum back to the ice. Shaw comes away with the puck. Poke checked away. Our first penalty. Blackhawks to the power play.
Williams will take the penalty for tripping. Uses his left foot on the play, and Dan O'Halloran, one of the officials, catches it and sends Williams to the penalty box.
Chicago has come up with some really big power play goals in the last two games that Joel Quenneville talked about that really sparked their team and gave them life. This is a big penalty kill here for LA.
Power play presented by Enterprise. Blackhawks in the series 4-19. Caves with Shaw and Kane, Keith and Seabrook. The referees are Dan O'Halloran and Wes McCauley. They worked game four. Each team awarded three power plays in that game. They did not call any penalties in the third period. Williams in the box for tripping. 7:53. Muzzin on the puck, keeps it away for Taves, and then it's cleared down ice by Dustin Brown.
Now, two reasons why LA's penalty killing has to be effective. They win the faceoff first and clear the zone, and then they force Chicago to dump the puck in and try to retrieve it. That's not their strength, and LA is able to clear that one as well.
This is Kane across the line for Seabrook. Seabrook with a shot in front, Taves scores! Jonathan Toews on the power play, 2-0 Chicago.
And this one, they're able to gain the blue line here. Kane gets the blue line, now makes a play, and this is a fortuitous bounce off the defenseman to a wide open Jonathan Toews. That was going to go wide on the short side. Toews just goes to the net. Look at the perfect bounce, and he puts it in for a 2-0 Chicago lead that goes right off the stick of Willie Mitchell.
Brent Seabrook knows he just wants to get the puck into the neighborhood of Patrick Kane. Patrick Kane is so hot, it goes in off his leg right to the front of the net. It's a slam dunk for Kane. But what a move by Kane right at the blue line amongst two or three LA Kings to dish it off to Seabrook on the attack.
Well, with Justin Williams in the box, Jonathan Toews with his fourth goal of the series, Blackhawks lead 2-0. Long shot by Stoll, stick beside by Crawford. Now comes out in front, got a big save by Crawford on Williams.
Well, Jared Stoll had a great look there. That play from behind the net, that was a quick play, a terrific save by Crawford. Look at Crawford, is not happy. Crawford's had his helmet and a mask ripped off his head. He wanted something done about that. Jared Stoll trying to stir it up here, Joe. And good idea to do it. Get LA back in the game here a little bit.
Yeah, try and get a change of momentum. And you're right, Brian. That was an excellent save. It looked like it might have been deflected. A kind of a bang-bang play from there. Deflected, and then that quick one. And Crawford with a real good save. And then Stoll actually gets knocked into him, and he says, well, I might as well, as long as I'm here, might as well pull his helmet and face mask off.
That's how it came off. That's why Crawford was upset. Jared Stoll grabbed the back of the mask and the helmet and ripped it right off. You got to get in the face of the goaltender literally sometimes.
Brian, it was interesting when you were interviewing during the pregame show, you were interviewing Drew Doughty and asking him what type of game he wants. He said, we want to win 2-1. He says, if we fall behind, though, by a couple, we might have to do some different things. Well, here they are down 2-0 early.
They want to control the game. L.A. wants to have a tight game. They'd love to have a 2-1. They're really good in that. That's why I asked them that question. What if you can't control it, will you go with it? Sometimes these games have a personality of their own, and they take you along for a ride that maybe you don't want. But L.A.'s won a lot of high-scoring games in the playoffs.
And they are not going to win this game 2-1. Shot by Mitchell. Mitchell's the net to the right. Over the first six games, 42 goals in the series, seven per game, and now a delayed penalty. It's against the Blackhawks.
Yes, Seabrook's going to go. It's going to be an interference call, I believe, at the side of the net. I think it was Tanner Pearson that he ended up pushing down into the net. The puck wasn't anywhere near. Right there.
Yeah, Joe Quenneville talked this morning. He says one of the areas that we have to be much better is around the front of the net. And they happened to start this game, but that's an obvious penalty.
Seabrook in the box. Carter with Kopitar and Gavrik. Doughty and Poitoff on the points. Big power play for Los Angeles. They are 6 for their last 13 in the series. Four of the goals coming from defensemen. That shot is blocked by Jarvison off the stick of Poitoff. Now Gavrik for Kopitar. Kopitar without a goal in the series. Now Doughty takes a shot. Hits Kopitar. Cross ice off the stick of Krueger. Jarvison on it for the Blackhawks. And he will clear down.
That was a little miscommunication by the Kings players. Muzzin going one way, Kopitar with the pass where he thought he'd be.
Puck comes out of the zone. Kings forced to regroup, trailing 2-0. On their first power play of the night as we hit the midway point of period one. Doughty's pass up the left wing for Gavrik. Now Voinov into the slot, off the stick of Kopitar, and out into the neutral zone.
One of the reasons why the LA Kings power play has been so successful in the last, as you mentioned, Kenny, with all these goals lately, is they've been able to find ways to get pucks through to the net. Not here in the early going of this power play.
Justin Williams battling with two Blackhawks in the corner. Sends it around to the far side. Puck is kept away from Alec Martinez. Held it at the line by Richards, but then deflected out by Krueger. 30 seconds remaining on the first Kings power play. They trail 2-0 on goals scored by Saad and Toews. Patrick Kane with two more assists. Now Justin Williams to the far side, Dustin Brown. Back out to Williams. Williams shot just misses to the left. Faced down by Richards. Knocked off along the boards by Ben Smith. Now Williams feeds Martinez. Now Doughty backs it up. Martinez with a shot. That is blocked. And carries out of the zone. Ben Smith with yet another block shot for the Blackhawks as Seabrook returns. Chicago kills off the first Los Angeles power play.
LA had plenty of puck possession, but they just simply couldn't get the puck through. Great job of penalty killing by Chicago.
Shots are 5-3 Blackhawks. Montel hit at the line by Toffoli. Throws the ball, bumps with Stoll. Duncan Keith ahead for Patrick Kane, and now Brandon Saad. 2-on-2 with Sean. Hook checked away by Voinov. Got played by Shaw for Saad. Saad carries it deep, around behind for Kane. Kane, 9 points the last 7 periods of regulation. Off the stick of Kane, tied up by Mitchell, out to the right point for Seabrook. Flipped in deep by Shaw for Kane once again. Looks to spin it out front, Mitchell stays with him. Seabrook, pushed out by Pearson.
Now you mentioned Patrick Kane. He said after game two that he was starting to figure something out about how to get more room on the ice. He's figured it out well.
Kopitar, nice move, shoots just wide. Bucks out to Muzzin. Now Kopitar. Muzzin holds in. Backhand shot. Blocked in front by Rosenthal. That will be cleared ahead by Brandon Bolin. Quickly back in come the Kings. Trevor Lewis has his shot blocked by Rosenthal. Hossa starts back the other way. Under 7 minutes remaining. First period. 2-0 Chicago. Kings nearly caught with too many men. They may have gotten away with one. This is the third 2-0 lead for the Blackhawks in this series. Kings have come back both times, once to tie the score and eventually lose an overtime in game five. In game two, the Kings came back from the 2-0 deficit, won the game 6-2. For extensive series coverage from the Stanley Cup playoffs, go to NHL.com from your computer or phone. Get video highlights and in-depth analysis of every game directly from the experts.
Well, we've talked about that throughout not only this series, but in previous series as well, about this LA Kings team, how nothing bothers them. They will fall behind. They find a way to get back in the game. They continue to try and play the same way. The Chicago Blackhawks, the same way.
Both teams so resilient in the Stanley Cup playoffs during these recent runs. Kings winning the Cup in 2012, Blackhawks in 2010, and again last year. The Kings this season 6-0 when facing elimination. The Blackhawks 9-2 their last 11 games when facing elimination.
They just have so much will in both these teams, and the fact that they've won championships with most of these players on the rosters, they know how to win, they know what it takes.
20 Stanley Cup winners on the Chicago side, Kings with 17. They met in the West Final last year. Blackhawks won the series in five. For the Kings, they're third straight trip to the conference finals. Blackhawks have been here four of the last 6 years. Puck played at center by Stein. Knocked down by Williams. Shaw flips to the corner. Matt Green is out into Los Angeles. Williams with three Blackhawks back. Stein pulls it out around Kopitar. Now Voinov. Far corner. Pearson lets it go through to the left point for Mitchell. Mitchell's shot gets blocked by Shaw. Sent ahead by Saad. And then Shaw moves it into the King zone. Blackhawks will make a full change. Chicago with a 2-0 lead. Saad at 5:06 and then Taves at 8:36. Puck was behind Oduya. He couldn't find it. And the shot by Toffoli off the goal post. Hit the right post behind Crawford. And now the Blackhawks have iced the puck.
Well, we talked about this line needing a big game. Kopitar was still on the ice, but Toffoli did make the change, and he was in front. Oduya had no idea where the puck was. Eventually, the shot right through the legs of Brent Seabrook and off the far post.
Chicago was stunned there because Oduya was stunned. It went off the glass and hit Oduya in the back. He felt it, didn't know why he felt it. It dropped in his feet, and they got the pass out into the slot. L.A. did got that quick shot.
But carried ahead by Hossa. Shots are 5-3. Chicago. Blackhawks without a shot since their second goal.
I actually think LA's done a good job of trying to slow this Blackhawks team down. Remember, they want to keep it low scoring and not allow Chicago to skate halftime. They've been pretty good in that area, yet still trail 2-0.
Nearly 8 minutes without a shot for the Blackhawks. Now the Kings have iced the puck. Well, Belmont Stakes Week begins Wednesday on NBCSN with the premiere of California Chrome, the unlikely champion, documenting his improbable rise to a possible Triple Crown. Then watch his chase for history. The Belmont Stakes, Saturday on NBC. Face off to the right of Jonathan Quick, Carter, and Kruger. Blackhawks lead game 7, 2-0. Brown unable to clear. Puck worked out for O'Dea. And now Carter back the other way for Dustin Brown on the left wing. Brown with a shot, and it's knocked in by Carter. Crawford made the save. O'Dea breaks his stick over the crossbar. The Kings have cut the Blackhawks lead in half.
Just prior to getting the rush on that particular play, Brown had turned the puck over. And now Oduya has a scoring chance, but fans on it, and here they come down the other way. This is just the wrist shot up in the air and the hand-eye coordination of Jeff Carter. Brown with the shot, Carter with the finish. John, above the crossbar, it's close.
Johnny Oduya's job there is to make sure he's looking around for anybody going to the net secondarily. And that guy was Carter. You can see that Carter was on the backside in the blind spot of Oduya, but it's Oduya's job to look around. That's why Oduya broke his stick over the crossbar afterwards. That puck was airborne. That was a heck of a save and an attempt and a wave there by Crawford to bat this out of the way, but Carter's eye-hand coordination is so quick, he puts it in. It looked like it was a good goal to me. That's why they're reviewing it, though. There's Jeff Carter taking a look at our monitor right now.
Does he think it's a good goal?
Of course he does.
Yeah, he's taking a good look at it there. Here it is again. The shot by Brown. He's normally on a line with Kopitar. That looked like it deflected on the way in.
It is really close.
Yeah, it is.
It's really close.
The height of the crossbar. The shot up in the air.
I think it has to be definitive that it's all over the crossbar. I think you get the benefit of the doubt there. To me, it looks like a good goal.
Well, they'll take their time and really look at this from every angle possible.
That's a big goal. I mean, Jeff Carter's come through with huge goals.
After reviewing the play, the puck was knocked in below the crossbar. We have a good goal.
I don't have an argument with the call. It was just too close. Remember, this was all after an icing. So they end up on a line together. Here it is again, up in the air. I think it's the right call.
Fifth goal of this series for Jeff Carter. Brown and Martinez, the assist. Now Bickle looking for Taves in front. Carried ahead by Trevor Lewis. And now Marion Gaborik. Gaborik, cross-ice pass to Muzzin, and he misses the net. Back the other way, Brian Bickle. 3 minutes to go, first period. Shot blocked by Doughty and gathered in by Jonathan Quick. Taves gave the Blackhawks a 2-0 lead, and then it was Carter for Los Angeles.
A lot in the last couple of days about a couple of things. Pace and your effectiveness in checking. What do you think about those two categories so far?
Great start. You know, we get that shot through there and they end up making it 2-1, so it's a ball game now, and Crow just makes a great save. But, hey, tremendous pace. The building's alive. A fun place to be.
Thanks, Coach.
All right, gotcha.
Jake Muzzin had a chance to make this a 2-2 game. Terrific play on the rush. Look at Muzzin coming late and how much time and room he had there. That is a terrific save, the one that Joel Quenneville was talking about by Corey Crawford.
Faceoff control by the Kings, who now trail 2-1. But carried ahead by Jared Stoll. Stoll and Letty. Off the stick of Shaw. King out to the right point for a shot by Voinoff, and Williams scores! Justin Williams does it again. It's his seventh goal in a game 7, which ties an NHL record. This game is tied in 2.
LA just comes up the ice with speed, and then they put pressure on the Blackhawks on the forecheck. Here they come. Nick Letty's back. He takes a hit. Support by Los Angeles, moving the puck around, and keep an eye on 14. There it goes. It goes off the defenseman, Roosevelt, right to Justin Williams in the net for a tie game.
The 1-2 punch there on the forecheck by Jared Stoll, and then the support by Williams himself. Right there, Williams came in as the second man. Comes out like a goal scorer, gets into the scoring area, gets a fortunate bounce, and doesn't need a second chance.
Justin Williams ties six-time Stanley Cup champion Glenn Anderson. His seventh goal in a game seven. And now the Blackhawks come right back and take a 3-2 lead. Patrick Sharp with his second goal of this series.
Right off the faceoff. You talk about an innocent-looking play. Turnover by Muzzin. He has it. He just kind of throws it in the area. L.A. has it, but there's the turnover in the neutral zone. And this little rolling puck, did it hit a stick? Might have hit a stick on the way in, and Quick just lost it, just missed it. Sharp's just trying to get the puck to the net. There it is. Oh, it
it's the bounce. Yeah, it bounced. It was a rolling puck, and it bounced up and over his stick and below his blocker.
The game was tied for 12 seconds.
Well, if anybody was due to have some good luck, it was probably Patrick Sharp. He's had a lot of shots, a lot of looks in this series and throughout the playoffs. He's been snake-bitten a lot, just cannot find the back of the net with the regularity that he normally does. And for Jonathan Quick, I mean, that was a nasty bounce. That's like a short hop on a hot grounder there for a shortstop, and you're trying to get it, and it just gets by you. He was fooled by that one.
Now Dustin Brown down the left wing. Blackhawks with a 3-2 lead. 2 minutes remaining. First period. Roy Mitchell sends to the near side. Dustin Brown in behind the net. Now out of front for Gavrik, and a glove save by Crawford.
Unbelievable. That was the 15th total shot of this first period, and we've had five goals.
Dustin Williams tied it. And then Patrick Sharp, 3-2, Chicago.
Watch how nasty this bouncing puck is for Jonathan Quick. It's going to bounce and curve. His angle looks really good. That looks impossible, and it goes in.
That looked like it was going wide by a foot.
Yes, I know.
Three goals in 63 seconds. Two, 12 seconds apart. Here is Williams. Now Seabrook plays it for the Blackhawks. 1:30 remaining, first period. Five goals on 15 shots.
The way this series has gone, the goal scoring, the top players playing against one another, goaltenders, at times great, at other times having trouble finding the puck.
Now Dwight King for Los Angeles. Battle for the puck, two Kings, two Blackhawks. Kopitar out for Doughty. Doughty fires one. It's off the side of the net. Seabrook moves it up the boards. Comes to Muzzin. Under a minute to play. First period in Chicago. Here is Kopitar. Directed back behind the net. Williams on it for the Kings. Now Dwight King. Out to Jake Muzzin. And his shot is deflected out of play. We told you that Justin Williams tied Glenn Anderson for Game 7 goals. How about this list? Game 7 points. Williams and Doug Gilmour, one ahead of Wayne Gretzky, Mark Messier, and Trevor Linden. Most points in a Game 7 all time.
The guy just gets it done. I mean, he's got so much heart. He attacks pressure when the game is on the line.
Now Jeff Carter with the puck, watched by Keith. And a huge save by Crawford. What a stop with his catching glove.
And that was Brown right off the faceoff. Again, there's some pressure by the LA Kings. They win a faceoff, and now they go to work. One shot off the side of the net. Carter with all the work from behind the net. And then that last move, and you could see Crawford was deep in his net, but that glove was quick.
Final half minute, period one. Duncan Keith. Puck played by Drew Doughty with 20 seconds.
20 seconds, Dewey!
Doughty spins away from Sharp, 15. Too far for Dustin Brown. Kings have iced the puck with 11.8 remaining.
Chicago's checking in their own zone has not been very good. Dustin Brown and the LA Kings have gotten some looks at the net. And Chicago's going to have to keep an eye on Drew Doughty's partner, Jake Muzzin. Jake Muzzin has had three outstanding looks at the net already. Hasn't gone in the back yet. But he's had some touch in this series. Chicago better be careful.
Carter and Taves to the right of Jonathan Quick. Saad directs it out to the point for Keith. Time winding down. Period one, game seven. Five goals on 18 shots over the first 20 minutes. Justin Williams tied the game, and then it was Patrick Sharp 12 seconds later for Chicago. Coming up, the Lexus Intermission Report with Liam, Mike, and Keith. What a wild first period here in Chicago. Patrick Kane, two more points. Winner moves on to the Stanley Cup Final. 3-2 Blackhawks after one. The Stanley Cup Playoffs at NBC are brought to you by GEICO. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance. And by Frost Brewed Coors Light, the game's most refreshing beer. 3-2 Blackhawks in Game 7. Joe, are players superstitious?
Well, Justin Williams is on the left, and that's Willie Mitchell. He says, I've got this old Brian Engblom stick. Maybe if I rub your stick with it, something good will happen. There it is. That's a 79 Cup stick, isn't it, Brian?
Yeah. You know who should have been rubbing the stick of Williams is Jake Muzzin, because those chances that Muzzin had in the first period.
That's right. You saw the note. The Blackhawks have scored on five of their last nine shots. They scored on their last two shots in Game 6. Their only two shots over the last 18 minutes of the third period in Game 6. Goals for Chicago on three of seven shots in the first period tonight.
You know, Mike Milbury and Keith Jones were talking about the skill level on these two teams. You almost feel sorry for the goaltenders a little bit, don't you? I mean, yes, both teams have to be better defensively, and then we looked at some of the crazy bounces that we saw, but these are two highly skilled teams that LA has gone from the team that had trouble scoring in the regular season now that they almost score at will.
The first period tonight, the third five-goal period of this series. Kings scored five in the third in Game 2. The teams combined for five goals in the first period of Game 5 and again tonight. Here's Patrick Kane, two assists in the first period. Moves the puck in deep, point off up the boards for Dwight King. Opening minute, second period. Kenny Albert, Joe Micheletti, Brian Engblom from the United Center in Chicago. Series tied at three. No icing, Seabrook. Back for the Blackhawks. Both teams make changes. Long pass up the right side for Taves. And now Hossa slides it across the top of the crease. Hossa without a goal in this series. This is Hossa again. And the save by Jonathan Quick.
Look at Brandon Saad on the bench there. He got shaken up right here in the neutral zone. Watch number 20 there, and it's Stoll that comes in from behind, and he gets that sort of whiplash action. He didn't see Stoll coming because he's coming from the backside, the blind side, and that whiplash, see him? He's shrugging that shoulder off.
Saad scored the first goal, Ben Taves. Blackhawks led 2-0. Kings, the next two, then Patrick Sharp. Oduya with a try, blocked in front. Then along by Oduya. And now it is Jeff Carter who clears. Seabrook for Chicago. Oduya up the left side. No icing. Quick waiting. Carter for Pearson. Blocked off of the line by Johnerson. Nicholas Johnerson for the Blackhawks. Shots are 11-8 Los Angeles.
Well, when it got to be 2-0 is when Daryl Sutter started making line changes. And that's when he reunited Carter up front.
We go inside the glass with a minute 56 gone in the second period. Brian Engblom.
The Los Angeles Kings are down 3-2, but you know what? They had a good first period. They were victimized by two nasty bounces. Look at the shot and the bounce off the backside of Kane. It goes right to Tate. Nothing anybody could do in that. And then this is one of the more miraculous goals I've ever seen. The Kings played solid. They did a lot of real good things. You can't have much worse luck than that about bouncing.
And the Kings did fight back from a 2-0 deficit. Goals 51 seconds apart by Connor and Williams. But then it took only 12 seconds after the Williams goal for Sharp to give the Blackhawks another lead. Jonathan Toews fends off Alex Martinez. Now Marian Hossa out in front, knocked back behind the net. Toews first one to it. Toews stick handling away from Matt Green. Toews shoots, saved by Quick. Puck is loose, and it's iced by the Kings.
That was another new line on the ice for Los Angeles, and they'll have to stay out there. A couple of real strong moves to the net. Toews does a good job of holding off Matt Green, big, strong, and Toews just throws it right to the front. Quick makes a save, tries to get it, gets kicked out of the way, and eventually Green just has to take the icing.
Good coverage by Carter in front of the net there, too.
We saw Brandon Saad shake it up moments ago, back on the ice with his line mates Shaw and Kane. Kings are offside. Joe, you mentioned Brian and the 79 Canadians winning their fourth straight Stanley Cup. Well, the Kings came back from a two-goal deficit in the first period tonight. Since expansion in 1967, this is the 19th game seven in a conference final or semifinal. That was the only time a two-goal deficit was erased in a game seven of a conference final or semifinal. May 10th, 1979, Bruins led 3-1. Montreal would come back and win the game in overtime 5-4.
Yeah, Mike Milbury and the Boston Bruins, they were outplaying us.
Mike just threw down his headset and he's walking out of the studio.
Fortunately, Mike does not have my number.
I'll give it to him.
Here's King into the corner for Williams. And the Blackhawks come away with the puck. Patrick Kane chips it up the boards around Muzzin. Stole back on it for Los Angeles. Brian, I should point out, neither you or Mike factored in the scoring that night.
Shaw went in to hit, pardon me, Kenny, but Shaw's at the bench now.
Yeah.
There's no penalty, but he went in to hit Jarrett Stoll after Stoll had moved the puck, and Stoll saw him coming. And I'm not sure if he got him with an elbow or the stick, but here it comes right there. Put his arm out and caught Shaw on the side of the face.
There's nothing wrong with that. It's not a penalty. I mean, Stoll's just protecting his space on the ice there. Got his arm up a little bit.
Looked like
Shaw's a little bit shorter. Yeah.
Looked like he got the shoulder more than anything.
Yeah.
Remember, Shaw missed the first two games of this series, but he has been a major factor on the line with Saad and Kane over the last three games. Gabbert bottled up by Jalmerson. Up comes to Hossa. Three Kings back as Hossa shoots in. Quick. Leaves it behind the net. Kept alive by Hossa. 4 minutes in, second period. 3-2 Chicago. Hossa out to Duncan Keith. Big drive and a left pass saved by Quick. Jonathan Toews knocked off the puck. Dustin Brown can't clear. Held it beautifully by Keith. Now Hossa and Brown. Voinoff ahead for Kopitar. Off the skate of Mitchell. Able to work it ahead for Kopitar. And now Gabbert. Looking for the trailer. Brown, who shoots, and it's blocked by Jalmerson. Smith on the puck for Chicago. Stick set by Gabbert, and now cleared out by Sharp.
Brown had four shots to lead LA in the first period.
Now Pearson for Toffoli. Toffoli for Martinez, and his shot is blocked by Ben Smith. Jalmerson able to clear. The Kings without a shot on goal in the period over the first 5 minutes. Blackhawks have three. Puck deflected along by Tyler Toffoli. Seabrook for Keith. And now Chris Prestige backhands out. Puck played by Ben Smith. Knocked off the puck by Jake Muzzin. Prestige comes in. And now Drew Doughty for Los Angeles. To Chicago. All the goals scored in the first period. Muzzin held off by Hontsius. Prestige works it ahead. Holzer and Doughty. Doughty up the boards for Muzzin. Over the stick of Shaw, who gets upended by Clifford. So Andrew Shaw back on the ice for Chicago. Nick Letty with a shot. Long rebound after the save by Quinn. And it's held in by Patrick Kane. Now Mike Richards around to the far side. Andrew Shaw for Brandon Saad. And now Patrick Kane. Now Saad looking for Kane. Pass broken up. Held in by Rosemont. Now it's forced out with 6.5 gone in period two. Kane back across. Leaving it for Shaw. Shouldered by Richards. Kane keeps it alive. Shovels it down low. And now Saad for Shaw. Kane and Muzzin. Muzzin loses a stick. Doughty behind the Los Angeles net. Shouldered by Saad. And the puck is worked free by Brandon Saad. Saad of the high slot. Shot blocked by Doughty. Another shot. And quick able to get the left pad on it. Now Kane. Kane turns and shoots. That is blocked. Penalty coming up to Los Angeles. Crawford to the bench. Power play. Blackhawks. And now some extracurricular activity. Shaw and Richards. Second power play for Chicago. They scored on their first.
Brandon Saad is going to take a shot from the top of your screen near the blue line, but I want you to watch the goalie. Watch quick. Watch it go down. Where is it? Where is it? Where is it? It hit him in the foot. He just goes down, tries to look around. He felt it afterwards. That's just good positioning.
And then with all that pressure, that was a long shift for that line. They draw a penalty on Mike Richards.
Richards for hooking, 7-0-1. Blackhawks, 1-for-1 on the power play. Puck held in at the line by Keith. And now Seabrook. Taves up front with Kane and Shaw. Puck cleared down ice by Kopitar. Blackhawks, 1-for-1 tonight, 5-for-20. In the series, they have scored a power play goal in each of the last three games. Puck bouncing on Kane. King has it for Los Angeles, and he clears.
You just see LA trying to stay up at the blue line, trying not to allow Chicago to carry the puck over the blue line.
Page knocked down by Doughty. Shaw comes in to play the puck. Shaw. Out to the point, Keith. Now the return for Kane and a shot. Turned aside by Quick. Shots are now 7-0 in the second period, Chicago. Taves out to Seabrook. The return for Jonathan Taves. And now across to Keith. He fires right out of the save by Quick with 47 seconds remaining on this Blackhawks power play.
Now Patrick Kane, once Chicago carries the puck in the zone, now they've got control, and Patrick Kane head up all the way, tries to beat Jonathan Quick up high, and Quick comes across and makes a right arm save.
This is the longest we've gone without a goal tonight.
It's been, it's really been a different kind of game, hasn't it? I think that LA has actually done a pretty good job of slowing Chicago down to a pace that they like, but now they're having trouble getting scoring chance.
Puck knocked out of the line by Patrick Sharp, who scored the last Blackhawks goal. Now Hossa looking across. Good play by Matt Green to break it up. Half minute remaining on the Richards fighter. Blackhawks with a 3-2 lead in Game 7. Winner will face the New York Rangers in the Stanley Cup Final beginning Wednesday in Chicago or Los Angeles. Saad unable to control. Here comes Kopitar with Brown. Dustin Brown down the left wing with a shot blocked and then Kopitar shoots it wide. And Crawford involved in a collision with Dustin Brown.
Brown was knocked down. That was not his fault. He was knocked down by, I believe, Patrick Sharp.
Dowdy with the puck. Penalty is over. Richards out of the box. Blackhawks 1-for-2. This is Richards. Sweeps it across for Gavrik. Gavrik sends towards the net. And a save by Crawford. That is the first King shot of this second period. It took 9.5 minutes.
What a beautiful touch pass, too, by Gavrik. Right out to a spot for Williams to get.
Now Johnerson up the boards and out.
And a really heads-up play by Carter coming off the bench, not touching the puck. There would have been a too many men on the ice penalty against Los Angeles.
Richards had tried to leap off, but he left the ice with Carter coming on. Ben Smith shouldered off the puck by Alec Martinez. And now Voinoff clears it ahead. Here come the Kings. Carter down the right wing for the circle. Forced behind the net. Tries to get it out in front. But a good play by Odunia to stay with Carter. And now the Blackhawks have iced the puck with under 10 minutes to go in period two.
Now we talked about Dustin Brown, who got knocked down. You'll see the collision right here was Sharp. Their skates come together. Brown goes down and then slides in to Crawford. Referee's right on top of that. That's a good non-call.
Three minor penalties have been issued to this point. Face off to the right of Crawford. Willie Mitchell with a try. Long carom off the end boards. Kept in the zone by Green. Knocked down by Odunia. Cuts away from King. And the puck is sent out by Bickle. Shot back in by Green. To Foley. Left it go through to King. King out to the right point for Green. And Toffoli knocks it in. Tyler Toffoli jumps on the loose puck. We are tied at 3.
That is another one of those bounces. The shot was blocked and then deflected right over to Tyler Toffoli. And you talk about a great pair of hands. The good job on the forecheck. Eventually the shot will come from the point. And I believe the shot block is here. And then there it is, right over the other side to Toffoli, who puts it in.
Incredible the changes of direction and the nasty bounces that have happened in this game. And I guess if LA was victimized by a couple in the first, they were certainly due one here, because it is a pretty good shot block in front. I think that was Michael Hanzus going down, but it goes off his foot. Tyler Toffoli gets a free one, but you have to be ready for those instinctively. That is a great set of hands there.
His fourth goal of this series. He scored in each of the first 3 games. Second point tonight for Toffoli. Blackhawks and Kings now tied at 3. Kopitar backhands in. Crawford waiting. The Los Angeles Kings, who have already won 2 game 7s on the road in these playoffs. No NHL team has ever won 3 road game 7s in one postseason. The only team to win 3, no matter where the games were played, the Boston Bruins in 2011. 2 at home, 1 on the road.
And Toffoli scores that. Again, the line change by Darryl Sutter takes Toffoli off the Carter line, and Toffoli scores.
Here's Carter. Carter with a shot. Crawford hangs on. 8.5 to play, second period. 7th of the playoffs for Toffoli. We are tied at 3.
A lot of goal scoring so far in this game. What are your thoughts on what you've seen so far?
Battled back from a bad goal. We battled back from 2. We battled back again from a bad third goal.
What about the pace of the game? Do you like the way your team has controlled the pace at different times?
Pace has been good for both teams. Kind of used everybody on the bench.
Thanks, Darryl.
Yeah.
Following the Game 6 loss on home ice, the first question asked to Darryl Sutter at the post-game press conference, what did you say to your team? His answer, the flight tomorrow is at 11.
He's great. He is very matter of fact.
Oh, a turnaround shot just wide to the left of Crawford. He also told us this morning that the Kings' best games in this series were games 1, 5, and 6, all losses.
All losses. I didn't think his team in game number 5, to me, the way they play, they were a little too loose in that particular game, but they did a lot of good things. But when you're playing against a Chicago team that's so talented, it's difficult to just be able to shut them down.
The Kings have come back from deficits of 2-0 and 3-2 to tie the score. Battle for the puck off the draw. It's Justin Williams. Williams sends it front off the skate of Seabrook. And now carried ahead by Patrick Sharp. Ben Smith. Smith with a long shot. Turned aside by Quick. Smith chasing down to the corner. Knocked to the ice. Kept alive by Krueger for Sharp. And now Willie Mitchell has it for Los Angeles. Around to Justin Williams. Picked off by Krueger, who knocks it back to Seabrook. They get along the boards and a penalty. As Willie Mitchell flattened Marcus Krueger. Mitchell to the box. Blackhawks to the power play.
This will be boarding against Willie Mitchell. LA's done a good job in this game of standing up and not allowing Chicago to carry the puck over the blue line much. But he steps up here. Willie Mitchell, big and strong, takes down Krueger, and that's a boarding call.
Boy, they called that one pretty tight for my liking. That was a pretty good hit. I thought he was careful about it. And yeah, Krueger went down, and yeah, it was close to the boards. You could see Daryl Sutter's quick reaction. He doesn't show very much with the referees usually, but it was enough to know he didn't like it.
Third power play for the Blackhawks, 1-for-2. Patrick Kane with the puck, out to Duncan Keith. And now Brent Seabrook with a shot. Kane once again, down to Taves, who has the goal tonight. Out to Seabrook, and now Keith. Shaw for Kane. Kane, backhand shot, played on the corner by Shaw. Up the boards for Taves. 30 seconds gone on the Blackhawks power play. Seabrook fakes a shot, Kopitar went down. Now Keith fires wide. And the puck comes out of the zone. Blackhawks must regroup.
Jonathan Quick doesn't mind those shots from the side. He tracks them really well. The shots that Quick doesn't want against him are the ones from the middle of the ice, straight down, because it's harder to control the rebound.
Kane was knocked down. You hear the fans' reaction. Shaw keeps the puck alive for Kane. And now Nick Leddy. Leddy with a drive right out of the save by Quick. And now another penalty. As Shaw was knocked down in front by Doughty. Another Kings penalty. Crawford off to the bench. With just under a minute remaining on the Mitchell minor.
Let him touch it.
Touch is made by Doughty. So a two-man advantage for 46 seconds. It is a cross-check. Drew Doughty to the box.
Drew Doughty has been the best player in this series. Penalty killing, power play, you name it. There's the one shot that goes through, and then you see the cross-check on Shaw, who's always around the front of the net.
I didn't think this was very smart by Chicago. Yes, they pulled a goaltender, but, I mean, give the puck to L.A. right away. Take the penalty and work the 5-on-3 rather than the 6-on-4. I thought they wasted valuable seconds there.
Exactly correct, Brian. Absolutely. Take it, give it up, get the whistle so you've got more time.
Two of their best penalty killers sitting right there, Doughty and Mitchell.
And Chicago takes the timeout, so that gives this group a little chance to rest, and then they get time to talk about how they want to work this 5-on-3.
Two Kings in the box, two defensemen, Mitchell and Doughty. Game one of the Stanley Cup Final, Wednesday night, either here or at Staples Center in Los Angeles. New York Rangers and the winner of this game. Pre-game on NBCSN at 7, and then the game at 8 Eastern on NBC.
Now, Chicago makes one change. They take Seabrook off the 5-on-3 and put a forward out there that's Sharp.
So four forwards, Sharp, Taves, Kane, and Hossa with Keith. And a big face-off win by Kopitar, allowing the Kings to clear down. A two-man advantage for the Blackhawks for another 35 seconds. Hossa. Hossa keeps it away from Kopitar. Out to Kane. And now Hossa, 25 seconds on the first penalty. Kane. Hossa. Keith. Back to Marion Hossa. Down low for Kane. 15 seconds on the two-man advantage. Hossa fires. Now Kane wants to play the puck. Down to 5 seconds on the first Kings penalty. Kane with a shot saved by Jonathan Quick. Mitchell out of the box. It's now 8-5-on-4.
The Kings did a really good job here of knowing that Hossa was going to be the shooter on this play. If you watch the body language of Keith, watch Keith. He's not ready to shoot. You don't have to run on him. You know he's not going to do anything. See, he's not even looking for it. So what does Kopitar do? Kopitar's a smart guy. No, I'm not getting over there. I'm going to stay in front of Marion Hossa because Hossa's the guy that's going to shoot.
And then Jonathan Quick, pretty good glove save on that shot by Hossa, who continues to lead the Hawks in shots, but having a difficult time finding the net.
11 games without a goal for Marion Hossa. Face off to the right of Quick. And it's 10 remaining on the power play for Chicago as the puck is cleared down ice by Mike Richards.
Now Chicago had plenty of time on that 5-on-3, and that shot by Hossa was the only one that they were able to get.
They had 46 seconds. As Brian pointed out, would have had more time had they given the puck away sooner. This puck gets off the skate of referee Dan O'Halloran. Comes to Jeff Carter. Ahead for Mike Richards. Richards killing some time, and now it deflects off a Kings player on the bench. 45 seconds to go on this Blackhawks power play in a 3-3 game.
Well, their shot.
And a Blackhawks penalty for slashing.
Okay.
So this will eliminate the Chicago man advantage. Teams will skate four aside for the next 45 seconds. Saad to the box.
Terrific work, boys, by the Kings. That was a clutch penalty-killing situation. There's the penalty right about there. That looks like the slash.
That broke the stick of Jeff Carter.
So the Blackhawks go from a 5-on-3 to a 5-on-4. Now, four skaters aside. Face-off control by the Blackhawks. Game 7, tied at 3. Western Conference Final.
Kruger did a nice job. He wins the face-off and goes right to the bench so Patrick Kane can come on the ice.
Now the steal by Richards. Richards, watched by Kane, slides it across off the skate of Smith. And now Seabrook will dive and work the puck ahead. Kane gains a step on Mitchell. Patrick Kane out in front for Duncan Keith. Puck loose. Keith looking for it. Smith is there. Backhand shot is blocked. Mitchell on it for Los Angeles as the penalty time winds down to Doughty. So now it is a Kings power play. Doughty out of the box. Jeff Carter with the puck. Now Andre Kopitar. Kopitar out to Alec Martinez. Takes his shot. Now Kopitar across from Muzzin. And his shot misses the net to the left. Kruger over for Chicago. Faceoff will come outside the zone after it deflects out. 54 seconds remaining on the Kings' man advantage.
There's Patrick Kane going up the wall, and there's Duncan Keith coming right down the slot. That's exactly the kind of play that Duncan Keith scored on in the last game to tie it up. Here's the Mike Richards forecheck. His timing is perfect. Johnny Oduya gets a bad pass, turns it over. Mike Richards was really upset at himself there that he didn't take the puck to the net and get a shot on goal, but it was a great forecheck.
We talked about Richards in prior game 7. He's been a factor for the Kings here tonight. The Los Angeles power play continues, but Taves comes away with the puck. Down to a half minute on this Kings power play. Under 4 to go, second period. 3-3 game. Dustin Brown out to the right point, Doughty. Now the return for Brown. Shot gets blocked by Oduya and cleared by Oduya.
The penalty killing of Chicago has been much better in this game as far as blocking shots, deflecting passes, not allowing pucks to get through.
Sean returns. Blackhawks back to full and equal strength. White King with the puck. He has two assists tonight. Out to Matt Green, and his shot gets blocked. Here is Saad. Smith had a stick lifted by King. Played at center by Keith. 3 minutes to go. Second period. Here come the Kings. Williams cutting wide. And now back the other way comes Shaw. Joined by Chalmerson. Two on one. Only Vaughn off his back. Chalmerson in front. Oh, a big save by Quick. But a penalty will be assessed. It is a hold.
What a turn of events. Duncan Keith gets caught in the neutral zone. Jalmerson's the only defenseman back. It's a three-on-one against him. He makes the play, and they turn it into a scoring chance on the other end.
Blackhawks to the power play. Trevor Lewis in the box for holding. Fifth Blackhawks power play. Chicago 1-for-4, including a 46-second two-man advantage. Taves with Kane and Shaw. Keith and Seabrook. 3-3 game, late second period, game 7. Taves around behind for Kane, and now Seabrook. And for Kane. To Shaw, setting up right side of the net. Carries in behind. Now the return for Kane, and then Seabrook. Takes a shot, over to Keith, right wing circle. Now Seabrook breaks a stick on the shot. Kopitar for Brown. Seabrook without a stick. Keith hustles back. Brown with a shot, glove save by Crawford. And a quick transition by Chicago, led by Kane. Kopitar got a stick on it. Great defensive play. Blackhawks hold in. And now it's cleared by Muzzin.
Nice job by Duncan Keith to come across there and put pressure on Brown. Seabrook had that no stick backing up there. Not much you can do when you don't have that stick in your hand. Really good job there coming over and putting pressure by Duncan Keith.
1 minute to go on the power play as Hossa did not get good wood on it. Quick without a stick. It's about 20 feet to his left. The drive by Sharp. He scores! Patrick Sharp with his second of the game. Quick lost his stick. Blackhawks regain the lead.
Well, Quick had to make a save on this rush by Chicago. Move the puck, get the line, that little one-handed pass. Quick didn't know how he stopped it, but he did. And then he loses his stick. He's looking around, trying to find it, and what a shot by Patrick Sharp.
Jake Muzzin is the one skating by that knocks the stick out, and then he's also the one that gets a piece of that, I think, and screens Jonathan Quick. You could see what Patrick Sharp saw, and you could see what Jonathan Quick didn't see on that one.
Joel Quenville told us this morning, Sharp's best two games of the series were the last two. He's been even better tonight with a pair of goals. Blackhawks scored twice on the power play for the first time since game one against Minnesota in the last round.
Patrick Sharp, too good of a player not to break out offensively at some point.
Now a shot from the left point by Mitchell misses the net. Comes the point off into the corner. Shaw up the boards for Saad. Knocked down by King. 1 minute to play, second period. Now Voinoff for the drive, blocked in front by Jalmerson, and carried out by Shaw. Shaw threw the penalty, which led to the power play goal. Sharp from Saad at 18:25. Now Kopitar with 35 seconds. Dropping it off for a drive by Martinez, and that one is blocked by Ben Smith. Blackhawks have done a terrific job blocking shots tonight. Behind the net is White King. Now Dustin Brown, 20 seconds. Now to Voinoff, another block. This time by the stick of Sharp. Martinez blocked by Ben Smith.
And Smith has got a bad arm too, I think, on the block, but he stays out there.
Two on one, Sharp with Kruger. And now Smith with a shot. That gets blocked. Time winds down. Second period comes to an end. In Chicago.
So Chicago had a 3-2 lead. L.A. comes back to tie it. And watch number six, Jake Muzzin, tries to block it. Looked like it just glanced off his left arm. And just inside the post past Jonathan Quick. That makes it 4-3 Chicago on the power play.
Shots of the second period. Blackhawks 16, Kings only 4. Discover Card intermission report coming up with Liam, Mike, and Keith. Patrick Sharp with his second go-ahead goal tonight. And the Los Angeles Kings have taken 5 penalties in Game 7. Winner will move on after 40 minutes in Chicago. It's the Blackhawks by 1. The Stanley Cup playoffs on NBC are brought to you by Lexus and their pursuit of perfection. And by Verizon, the official wireless partner of the NHL. Third period in Chicago. Blackhawks lead 4-3. There is Jarrett Stahl as we send it down to Brian. He did not play over the final 8 minutes of period two.
Yeah, he went into difficulty along the boards right about here. He's going to go down. You don't get a real good look at it. But when you watched him, when he came back up, he was wincing, came right to the bench, and he went off. 5-for-8 in the faceoff circle so far in this game. Andre Kopitar had to take over. Kopitar 12-for-18 because of it. The good news, Stoll's at least on the bench. We'll see how much he plays.
Blackhawks with a 1-goal lead as we start the third period. Chicago has won their last 13 games, 5, 6, and 7 in the Stanley Cup playoffs. Kings have won a pair of Game 7s on the road over the Sharks and the Ducks. 88th game of the Stanley Cup playoffs. Will this be the final period prior to the Stanley Cup final? We take a look at tonight's Coors Light Cold Hard Facts. Blackhawks, most game-winning goals in one postseason. Dustin Byfuglien with 5 during the Stanley Cup March in 2010. Kane and Taves both with 4 this year. And how about Darryl Sutter back in 1985?
And then you throw Bobby Hull in just for good measure.
Darryl Sutter now working to defeat the Blackhawks and advance to the Stanley Cup final for the second time in 3 years as Kings head coach. Opening minute, third period. Patrick Sharp with the go-ahead goal for the Blackhawks on the power play.
There's Stoll up there.
There's Kane with the puck. Shaw knocked out. Racing over is Saad. And now it is cleared ahead by Stoll. For the Blackhawks, 2 points apiece for Sharp, Kane, and Saad. On the King side, to Foley and King. With 2 points. Here comes Pearson for a backhand shot off the left shoulder of Crawford. Green back to Los Angeles, met by Kruger. Now Jeff Carter for the Kings.
That last chance by LA, that puck getting somebody near the Chicago bench allowed LA to get the puck and turn that into a scoring chance.
Kruger with Sharp. Long shot by Kruger. Quick has it.
Mike Richards made a heck of a pass on that broken play in the neutral zone, Joe. The backhand pass and the defense of the Chicago Blackhawks overcommitted to one side. Look at Richards take a look in the middle, and there's the streaking Pearson. Nick Leddy had converted too far over to one side, overloaded. Look at Leddy. He's not looking away from the puck. Chicago defenders have done that on a number of occasions in this game, and it hasn't burned them yet.
Kings control the draw. This is Gabbert. Met by his good friend and neighbor during the offseason, Marian Hossa. Puck set towards the net. And Quick will cover with Taves tied up in front by Doughty. Call Star NHL to download NHL Game Center. Get a free premium upgrade only on Verizon. Enjoy exclusives like free live NBC National games. Never be without hockey.
Brian, it'll be interesting, and you talked about this, how well Mike Richards has played in Game 7s in this postseason. Well, he's only played 7 minutes and 35 seconds through two periods. It'll be interesting to see how much Darryl Sutter plays him here in the third. He's out on the ice now taking the faceoff.
Yeah, doubling up with two centers out there for faceoffs. Carter is out there too, continuing.
Sharp wins the draw from Richards. Moving in for the point is Oduya. Shouldered by Carter. And the puck is sent ahead off the stick of Richards. Kings would have had a two-on-one.
Well, it went off his skate first. He kicked it, tried to get control of the puck with the stick, and could not.
Now Mitchell around to Voinov. No icing. Crawford waiting for the puck. Ahead to Oduya. 2.5 gone, third period. Game 7. Blackhawks with a 4-3 lead. Chicago has iced the puck.
Yeah, this third period starting off very conservative. Lead by the Chicago Blackhawks. Patrick Kane has had a little bit more of a difficult time in this game finding some of that open space that he's had in the previous couple of games, but nonetheless has been effective again for the Hawks.
Blackhawks control, it's Kane. Lee Kane's back. Dustin Williams on the puck. Drew Doughty. Williams. Cutting wide on Rosenvall. Williams slides one across. Crawford got a stick on it. And Saad sends the puck out of trouble. Deflected along by Kane. And then a good play by Muzzin. Now Saad into the corner for Kane. Andrew Shaw. Back around off the stick of Kane. And it's cleared ahead by Muzzin for Stoll. Williams in pursuit, along with Lenny. Marion Hossa flips in around Matt Green. Martinez back for the Kings. 3.5 gone by, third period. 4-3, Blackhawks. Martinez into the Blackhawks zone. Dustin Brown in behind the Chicago net. Up the boards for Kopitar. And now Brian Bickell flips it ahead, knocked out of the zone by Jonathan Toews, and played at center by Marion Hossa. Around he comes to a waiting Bickell, shoved by Green. Kopitar on the puck. Gabrick, good play by Smith, and he'll move it back down. Kruger, knocked off the puck. Gabrick will clear. Seabrook back to the Chicago zone. Oduya to a waiting Kruger. Kruger with a shot. Blocked it into the netting by Quick.
LA making a change. Johnny Oduya with a real good play, recognizing he had time and that Kruger was wide open the far blue line. There's the change on the left by the LA Kings, and there's the alert play by Oduya, and this shot, just the second of this third period for Chicago. Here it is again. Good puck movement way to the far side. LA, no one on that side. Kruger takes advantage.
Kruger remains out for the draw with Carter to the right of Quick. Two shots in the period for the Blackhawks. Kings have one. Blackhawks had leads of 2-0, 3-2, and now 4-3. Moved out of the zone by Toffoli, played by Voinov. Into the Blackhawks, having a long shot. It is handled by Crawford, who had some trouble with it.
Joe, you talked about Patrick Kane not getting much room out there. Watch out his last shift off the faceoff. He's going to get the puck coming out of the zone. Now watch how quickly white jerseys go to number 88. Pressure from the side, Stoll on him, Muzzin standing up on him, and a support guy behind running into a brick wall almost everywhere. They don't want to let him skate through the neutral zone and get the blue line.
9 points the last three games for Patrick Kane. 2 assists tonight, scored the game winner in game 6. Oduya. No icing. Back to play, it is Mitchell. Blackhawks make a full change. This is Voinov. Up the middle. Toffoli backhands in. We've played 5 minutes in period 3. Game 7 in Chicago. Keith for Shaw with Saad and Kane. Pass across. Just a little of the stick of Kane. Now Kane into the corner for Saad. Saad to the net. Backhand shot is blocked. Blocked by Mitchell. Cleared ahead for Carter. Johnerson is back. Carter misses the net. Williams could not hold in. Buzzing on the puck to Los Angeles. And now Drew Doughty. Doughty with a tough angle shot. And now Keith clears it ahead for Holson. Held in at the line. And now Keith up the left side. Kept away from Bickel by Doughty.
Chicago's done a good job of keeping Doughty out of the offense of this game. Fans don't like this icing call. That was one of the few times that Doughty was up on the ice on the offense.
Watch Brandon Saad on his last shift coming out of the corner here. Terrific balance and hard work. We're going to make a quick move on Mitchell. Look at this. He's almost pushed off balance. Mitchell's got the inside path for him. Uses the free hand on him and pushes him. But Saad, who's had a terrific influence on this series the last couple of games, makes it to play to the net.
Gaborik with the puck. Steered into the corner by Crawford. And the net was knocked loose.
Dustin Brown going hard to the net.
Just over 6 minutes gone. Third period. 4-3 Blackhawks.
What a classic battle this has been. Jonathan Toews against Andrei Kopitar. Game 7. They've gone at one another for 7 games now. In this game, Kopitar, no goals, no points, no shots. And Toews has a power play goal.
Kopitar, no goals in the series. Toews has 4. They have battled and battled throughout these 7 games. There's Brian Bickel. Bickel keeps it away from Doughty, and now Holson. Holson in behind the net for Toews. Kopitar right with him. Holson, turnaround shot, stick save by Quick. And it's skated out by Kopitar. Flipped along for Dustin Brown. Drops it off to Kopitar. Kopitar still with the puck. Across to the left point, Martinez's shot. Save made, and it's covered by Crawford.
Good look there for Martinez. He had to get it away quickly. He does get the shot to the net. I talked to Martinez this morning, and he was really hard on himself after last game when he had that wraparound attempt for a goal. Had about 4 feet in net and couldn't put it in the empty net after a good play by Johnny Oduya. In this game here, just a moment ago, moving in from the point, gets the shot, and his job is just to get it on target and see what happens from there.
Face-off control by the Kings. Pearson looking for the puck. Blackhawks come away with it. It's Sharp, who has 2 goals on the night. Blocked off of the line by Martinez. And now Sharp directs it back to Seabrook. Martinez for the Kings. To Mike Richards. Tanner Pearson with a drive, blocked by the stick of Seabrook. Deflects out of play.
20 shots on goal now for the LA Kings. 5 shots in this period. A good solid defensive play by Seabrook. Stick in the right spot. And Chicago's done a better job of that. Their coverage, as Joe Quenneville has talked about in front of their net, at times has been good. At other times, not as good as it needs to be. And here they trying to defend a 1-goal lead with under 13 minutes remaining.
Kings with the draw. Mitchell with the puck. Williams. Watched by Shaw. Good pressure by Shaw, allowing Hodges to clear. Barry back in and flipped into the corner by Voinov. 5 goals on the first 13 shots of this game. But things have settled down. 2 goals on the last 33 shots for the teams combined.
A lot of crazy bounces in this game. We've talked about them. We've shown them on both goaltenders. We've had goals scored against them where they didn't have a chance because of deflections or bounces.
5 goals in the first period, a record for a game 7. There have now been 49 goals scored in the series.
And that's why these coaches, especially Daryl Sutter right now, will continue to tell his team, keep throwing pucks at the net. Get players going there, get the puck towards the net.
Gabrick and Shaw. Kane comes in. Now Johnerson. And the skates of Gabrick. Shaw, stick checked by Kopitar. Kept alive by the Kings, but now skated out of the zone. And moved to the Los Angeles line by side. Now Dustin Brown. 11 and a half remaining. Third period in Chicago. Here's Doughty leading the rush. Doughty puts the center. Deflected away by Johnerson. And now carried down the left wing by Bickle. Bickle across. And he could not get it through to Holson. Kopitar. That shot blocked by Holson. Now coming in to Foley. Cuts behind the net and then Crawford got a pad on it. It looked like Toffoli tried to back it in off the goal.
Yeah, he had him out of the net a little bit. Then Crawford with the left leg was able to prevent that puck from going in front.
Here's Toffoli. Now Seabrook for the Blackhawks. Knocked down at center by Voinov. And then played ahead by Krueger. Shuffle the right circle and a save by Quick on Ben Smith. Puck kept away from Smith. Now it is Voinov. Kings back up ice, trailing by a goal. Richard moves it around for Carter. Carter and Keith. Now Toffoli comes in. Toffoli out to the right point. Voinov fires right on. A save by Crawford.
Drew Doughty on the attack. They're down by a goal. You know he's going to step up whenever he can offensively. He gets surrounded by a couple of Chicago Blackhawks, tries to go across the ice. Martinez with a terrific play on the two-on-one. Look at that stick positioning there on the attempted pass from Bickle to Marian Hossa. And then another chance when Voinov got caught. Another two-on-one. Ben Smith made the calculated right shot, and it was really well played by Jonathan Quick to kick that one off to the side. If you shoot it low to the far side, maybe you have a chance for a rebound, but Quick made sure there was none.
Face off to Crawford's left. Here's Doughty. Muzzin. Muzzin shot the flex wide. Johnerson ahead for Holson. And now for Steve. Under 10 minutes remaining in regulation here in Chicago. The winner will advance to face the New York Rangers. For Steve, knocked off the puck by Doughty.
Doughty's hurt. That hurt him.
Buck Stover heading for the Kings bench. Drew Doughty, who said, they took the cup from us, now it is our turn. Willie Mitchell with a drive off the glove of Crawford, and Keith will backhand ahead for Hossa. Stick checked away by Voinov. Around behind for Mitchell. Off the skate of Dustin Brown. Johnerson. And now Keith.
Doughty finally starting to look like he's getting a little more comfortable on the bench. He made a beautiful defensive play.
Doughty comes in on Versteeg. Chris Versteeg's hardly had any shifts in this game, but Doughty sees him. We had him ISO, and he comes across just as Versteeg tries to control the puck right in the dead slot. Here's Versteeg again, puts between his feet. Doughty comes across, and as soon as he hit him, I saw him wince, and he went right to the bench.
Johnerson on the puck for the Blackhawks. Kept it at the line by Carter. And now Keith backhands down. This will be an icing. It's 8:49 on the clock.
And here comes Doughty. Quick break, little bit of a rest. Was able to gather himself. And right back on the ice.
Shots in the third period, 8-4 in favor of the Kings. No goals in the third. Johnerson for Krueger. Knocked out at the line by Muzzin. Played at center by Ben Smith. And then back to Seabrook. Here's Oduya shooting in. No icing as the puck was played by Quick. Buzz it ahead for Justin Williams. Patrick Sharp with the go-ahead goal. Blackhawks lead 4-3. Puck knocked out of the air by Hamzoots. Hamzoots stopped by the goal stick of Quick. Toffoli on the puck for the Kings. Here's Dowdy. 8 minutes to play. Now Toffoli. Justin Williams. Tyler Toffoli with a shot. Wide to the right. Billy Mitchell. And a good play by Andrew Shaw to knock it out of his own. Going off up the middle, deflected along, kept away from Brown by Keith. Bickle. Into the near corner with 7.5 to play.
Chicago's doing a nice job in the neutral zone.
Here comes Brown. Kate stayed onside. Walker save. Score! Marion Gaborik ties the game with 7:17 remaining.
Chicago had been playing four men back in the neutral zone until now. Now they get two forwards. Actually, all three forwards caught on the breakout pass. And so LA finally has a little bit of room. And eventually this shot on the rebound will go off the goaltender Crawford and into the net. And Gaborik scores his 12th of the playoffs.
It looks like an innocent play, but the coverage in front of the net, net front presence, and the lack of coverage by Chicago, which has been a lot better in this game. They just let Gaborik go for a second. There are two Chicago Blackhawk players there, but they're just standing in front of the net, and Gaborik gets the fortunate bounce, and he doesn't need the second chance.
Yeah, Brian, that was one of the few times in this third period where Chicago gets caught in the offensive zone, being too aggressive.
The last King to score as many as 12 goals in the playoffs, Wayne Gretzky, 1993. Gaborik has 12 this year. Now a shot by Potter, blocked in front. Potter keeps the puck alive. Now Tanner Pearson into the slot. Dowdy still controls. Keeps it away from Seabrook. Out to the point for Muzzin. Muzzin fires. Saved by Crawford. Seabrook knocked to the ice. Pass out in front and a save on Pearson by Crawford. Marion Gaborik has tied Game 7 for the Los Angeles Kings.
The most dangerous player on LA is Marion Gaborik. There's two Hawks players right there with him. You've got to communicate. Someone has to stay with him. He's still on the right side. Look at the Hawks players. There's plenty of players there. They let him go. He puts it in to tie the game.
Kings outshooting the Blackhawks here in the third period, 12-5. Chicago has iced the puck. Gaborik from Brown and Kopitar at 12:43. So the Kings, for the third time tonight, have tied the game. They have never led.
You know, a play like that, the wing, which is Hossa, and the defenseman, which is Jalmerson, two excellent defensive players, forget to communicate. Someone has got to take the most dangerous player on Los Angeles. No one does, and Gaborik makes them pay.
Kopitar and Taves. Dowdy with the puck, spins away from Saw. Across to Muzzin, fans on the shot. Dustin Brown with the puck. Out to the point, Dowdy keeps it at the line. And then it's ripped from him by Saw. Saw slides it across for Hossa. And he is knocked off the puck by Dowdy. Tipped ahead by Gaborik for Kopitar. Tied at 4, just over 6 minutes remaining in regulation. Brown for Kopitar. Up the boards, Voinov. Met by Shaw. Now across to Hossa, Blackhawks offside.
Muzzin and Dowdy do a terrific job under pressure. Drew Dowdy gambles at the blue line, right side of your screen. The toe drag, not a good idea, but watch Muzzin. It's a 2-on-1, but he points to Dowdy. He figured out who the most dangerous player was, moved over. Muzzin did. Dowdy was hauling it back to get up. It was his mistake that caused it. He gets back and takes Hossa out of the play.
Neutral zone draw, controlled by the Blackhawks. Bickle shoots in. Bickle and Mitchell. Bickle around behind. Kept alive by Kane. Kane for Shaw. Misses the net to the right. Comes out to Letty. Puck looked like it was in the equipment of going off to flex out. 5:34 remaining in regulation. Blackhawks and Kings tied 4-4.
This tie game, Chicago had a quick start to this game. Just over 5 minutes in, Brandon Saad scores to make it 1-0 and a power play goal. Just minutes later, Jonathan Toews makes it a 2-0 game. Jeff Carter comes back to get LA on the scoreboard. And then one more, Justin Williams, Mr. Game 7, ties it. And this, still in the first period, a bouncing puck by Sharp makes it 3-2. Tyler Toffoli on a redirection, ties it. Sharp again, this time a power play, 4-3. And then here in the third, Marion Gaborik ties it late.
So with 5:24 remaining, it is 4-4. Gaborik with his 12th of the playoffs. One of his former teams, the New York Rangers, have advanced to the Stanley Cup Final, Game 1 on Wednesday.
He had a couple of wonderful years in New York. A couple of 40-goal seasons for Marion Gaborik.
Matt Green angles the puck to the corner, away from Ben Smith. O'Dulia keeps it in at the line. Now Mike Richards across to Tanner Pearson. Pearson with a shot, long rebound, after the save by Crawford. Ben Smith with 5 minutes remaining in regulation. To the net, covered by Quick.
Boy, what a good play by Matt Green.
There have been 50 goals scored now in this series. I don't think a lot of people expected that. So the story of the series hasn't been incredible goaltending for either team. It's been spotty at times. It's been brilliant at times. Now it's got to be timely. And how about Game 6 after the second period? One of my favorite moments in playoffs in a long time. The confrontation which Crawford started and Quick. Now they're going nose to nose. Who's going to blink?
50 goals in the series. The NHL record for a 7-game series is 61. I do not think we will reach that. Calgary and San Jose in 95. .440 remaining. Tied at 4. Hossa with a shot knocked out by the glove of Quick. Hossa again. Another save by Quick. Puck is loose left side of the net. Bickle is on it there. Kept it away from Brown. Bickle back up on his skates. Looking for Toews. Knocked down by Kopitar. Now Bickle out in front, but could not get the puck through to Hossa.
Boy, two good efforts by Hossa, and then there might have even been a third save by Quick on Jonathan Toews on the side of the net.
Duncan Keith. Watched by the forechecking Dwight King, and now it's Michael Rosenwald. Shots at 31-28 Blackhawks in a 4-4 game. 4 minutes remaining. Andrew Shaw off his stick. Point off, and Shaw. Shaw for the ice. Puck up the boards, and out. It deflected. Face off in the King zone to the right of Jonathan Quick.
Marian Hossa has not had a lot of looks at the net in this game so far, but this was a terrific shot. That's a really good look. They shoot it in between the defender's legs pretty often, these forwards, and it's a tough look for the goaltender. You can see Jonathan Quick on the follow-up plays as well. Quick with two really good saves.
Face off to his right, Saad and Carter. Off control by the Kings. This is Muzzin. Deflected down by Richards. Played by Seabrook. This will be an icing. Face-off coming back into the Chicago zone with 3:36 remaining.
Well, and Daryl Sutter is going with three lines here in this third period as Joe Quenneville tries to match wits with that man. And one of those nine regular forwards, Mike Richards.
Richards and Shaw to the right of Crawford. Kings have come back to tie the game three different times. Puck set up the boards by Shaw for Saad. Out the center, it's Voinov. Now Seabrook. Voinov shoots back in to the right of the Blackhawks goal. Seabrook got it there. But now Patrick Kane. Here comes Kane. Into the Kane zone. Mitchell back to Los Angeles. Off the skate of Gavrik. Played by Kluber for Saad. Saad stick handling. Into the corner for Kluber. Kluber with a shot. Left pass saved by Quick. Kluber knocked out by Voinov. Kopitar on the puck. Across to Willie Mitchell. Gavrik. Gavrik for Kopitar. Knocked away by Keith. 2:35 to play. Patrick Sharp, who has two goals tonight, looking for a third, and it's stopped by Jonathan Quick. The last time, Game 7 of a conference final went to overtime, 1994. Stéphane Matteau with the game winner, sending the Rangers to the Stanley Cup final with a Game 7 double overtime goal against a young Martin Brodeur, Hammer, New Jersey Devil.
And now Jared Stoll taking just about every defensive zone faceoff.
Puck played by Muzzin. Rolls down into the Blackhawks zone. Icing, Kings.
That last shift for Jeff Carter. Going into the end wall, he just kind of winced a little bit when he came back to the bench. He hasn't been quite right. Just this little bit of a collision here. His leg just kind of buckled under him there. Left leg was kind of jammed up against the boards. Came back, looks like he's okay now. They can't afford not to be able to play him in the last couple of minutes. It looks like he's regained himself now.
Now Saad will try and face off and win a draw against Stoll. He can't.
Muzzin clear. Broke the ball for the Blackhawks. Puck played by King.
Rosie!
Throws the ball around behind for Oduya. Puck held in by Stoll. Now Oduya with 2 minutes remaining in regulation. Tied at four. Jeff Carter with the puck. Deflected along by Pearson. Crawford out to his left. Winds it around for Jalmerson. Here's Taves for Keith. Keith with a big drive off the glove of Quick. Puck played by Taves. In behind, it's Mitchell. Now Voinov. Stick check by Hossa. Keith with a shot. Taves chasing after the rebound. Taves with the puck. Out for Seabrook, a shot. Loose in front. And it is Voinov. Stick handles out of trouble. Down to a minute 15. Duncan Keith unable to get the shot away, and Pearson will clear for Carter. Jeff Carter shoots. That is blocked by Seabrook and deflects to the netting with 1:06 left to play.
Duncan Keith had a couple of great scoring chances, and that's what he's thinking about right now. Watch this shot. Jonathan Quick just fights this one off. A high riser just off the tip of the glove going for the top corner. And then watch top of your screen. If he had to do this one over, I think he'd like to pull the trigger right away rather than try that curl and drag. It's easy to say after the fact, but Duncan Keith, dangerous there twice.
Face-off control by the Blackhawks. Ben Smith with 1 minute remaining. Ahead to Marcus Kluber. Kluber down the right side. Pushed off the puck by Gowdy. Now it's Ben Smith. Stick checked away by Muzzin. Kluber in the corner. Smith comes in. Up the boards, Jonathan and Gavrik. 45 seconds. Hand pass leading in the defensive zone. Now Dustin Brown. Brown, nice move on Oduya. Brown to the net. And a left hand save by Crawford. Now Gowdy. 30 seconds remaining. Andrew Shaw. Patrick Sharp. Down to 20 seconds. Voinov. Away from Shaw. Seabrook. With 12.
No!
Saad. Shaw with a shot. Oh, and a glove save by Quick. What a spectacular save by Jonathan Quick. Now 5.3 seconds remaining in regulation.
The beautiful passing by this line. That's been so dangerous over the last three games. And one more chance. Shaw gets it to the net. Quick fights it off and then finds the puck.
Look at this individual effort by Brown. Johnny Oduya was sort of stumbling getting over there, so Brown took advantage of him. Then he curled and dragged a couple of times almost around Jalmerson.
5.3 seconds. Face off to the right of Quick. Kings control. Game 7 of the Western Conference Final is headed to overtime. Goals scored in the series. There will be one more. Subway overtime intermission report coming up. Liam, Mike, and Keith. Marion Gaborik keeps the season alive for the Kings. And for the first time in 20 years, a Game 7 in a conference final means sudden death. The New York Rangers await the winner, 4-4, for 60 minutes in Chicago. Overtime goal scorers on both sides. Patrick Kane has three career overtime series winners. Only five times in NHL history has a team scored in overtime in Game 7 to advance to the Stanley Cup Finals. The last, the New York Rangers in 94, Stéphane Matteau. Prior to that, Yvon Lambert, Montreal, 1979.
You know, Kenny, the way these two teams have played in this series, it's fitting, isn't it, that this should go to overtime of a Game 7. It's been that close.
The Kings have never played a Game 7 overtime. The Blackhawks, in these playoffs, have won their last four overtime games after dropping their first two.
Now, the thing to remember here in this overtime, it's the fourth period, so both teams have a long change. Shift length is very important for both teams.
Overtime underway. Jonathan Toews with the puck. Nicklas Hjalmarsson. Blocked off by Muzzin. Dustin Brown. Shot blocked by Hjalmarsson. Brown, the Kings captain. Now Hossa back the other way. Hossa with six shots in the game. It's not scored in the series. This shot deflects into the left pad of Quick off Duncan Keith. Drew Doughty backhands along. Dustin Brown, cut angle shot, saved by Crawford. Kruger has it for Chicago. The team that scores the next goal will advance to the Stanley Cup Final. Overtime, Game 7. Keith, unable to clear. Carter with the puck. Now Matt Green. Green with a shot. Directed into the near corner by Crawford. And now a save on Martinez by Corey Crawford. Here's Martinez again for Tanner Pearson. Pearson with a shot. Another save by Crawford. Carter tries to get it out in front. Sticks away from Richards. Set ahead by Sharp. Here's Sharp down the left wing. Patrick Sharp has it. Knocked off his stick by a sliding Martinez. Kruger chips it in behind to Ben Smith. Blackhawks in the midst of a change. Kruger with the puck. Now Smith hit by Green. Puck picked up by Richards. And he will backhand down. Hjalmarsson for Chicago. Gets it away, but Williams did not capitalize. Patrick Kane on the ice for the Blackhawks. Puck backhanded along by King. Pressure from Stoll. Puck comes to Williams. Out to Mitchell on the left point. Now Justin Williams. Williams with a shot. Blocked by Hjalmarsson. Andrew Shaw. To the net, it's Kane on a save by Quick. Burst of speed by Saad, and he was stopped. Now Mitchell, deflected by King. Kane works it back into the Blackhawks zone for Seabrook. Puck deflected up off Jared Stoll, out of play with 2.5 Got it overtime.
What an opportunity for Saad. He turns on the speed, takes the pass from Shaw, and has this chance, and then goes heavily into the boards. Good save by Quick, and then Saad was slow to get up.
That was Voinov back-checking there. The roles were reversed. Voinov does a good job to get a stick in there. But it was Justin Williams playing defense, and he doesn't realize quickly enough that the most dangerous guy is the guy who's skating the fastest. And he didn't turn in time. Williams was beaten on the play by Saad. Voinov saved the day.
That's twice in overtime that the L.A. defense have been caught up for an odd-man rush for Chicago.
Now the Taves and Kopitar units out once again. Kopitar, Gabbert, and Brown, the forward line for Los Angeles. Taves with Mitchell and Holson for Chicago. Brown overskates. Kopitar plays the puck. In behind the net for Dustin Brown. Out to Jake Muzzin. Now Brown backs it up and shoots. Blocked in front. Never made it through to Crawford. Jarvison on it for the Blackhawks. Jarvison waits. Pass too far for Bickle. Blackhawks have iced the puck.
Joe, you made a great point about the first period and in overtime. You're a long ways from your own bench, and you have to keep the shift length short. There's a lot of fatigue. Both teams noticed it a lot in the third period. A lot of fatigue. Mental fatigue, anxiety will take your legs away too. But seven games into overtime, a lot of big hitting, tired legs out there, a lot of extra effort.
That guy right there had a chance to skate up the ice with it, and I think he was so fatigued, as you mentioned, Brian, that he coasted, and tried to make a pass that turned into icing.
Carter and Taves on the faceoff, shot by Richards, blocked in front by the stick of Oduya. Puck carried ahead by Hossett, and now Bickle. Bickle to the Kings line, shot blocked by Matt Green. Blackhawks make a full change. Martinez with the puck. Tied at four in overtime. Green up the right side, deflected along, and Crawford will hold on.
Smart play by Crawford. Puck coming in slow to him. Why take the chance? Take the whistle, get the faceoff, even though you're at a disadvantage against Los Angeles with the way they win faceoffs. Even though coming into overtime, Chicago's been pretty good, slightly better than LA in this game.
Face off to the left of Crawford. Puck forced out by Sharp. Patrick Sharp with speed. Sharp carries in behind the net, centers, but it's picked off and cleared out by Dwight King. Keith back on the puck for Chicago. Now Sharp. Three Kings back. Sharp with two goals in the game. Out for a shot on a clutch save on Letty by Quick.
Sharp seems to have the most energy out of all the Hawks players. Boy, he's had a couple of chances. He's been skating here in overtime. Here he is again. Tries to take point off to the outside. Eventually just gets the puck back to the point for the shot, and Quick with the easy save.
Now Joel Quenneville sends out Shaw, Saad, and Kane for the offensive zone draw. Shaw and Kopitar. Shaw wins it. Here is Keith to Patrick Kane. Backhands along for Shaw. Saad behind the net. Out in front for a shot by Kane, which is gloved by Quick.
Great read by Doughty. Doughty knew who the dangerous guy was. It was him, 88. 88's got a touch for being in the right place in key situations. Kopitar has trouble handling it. Nice work there by Saad, and look at Doughty. Doughty got over there in time so that Patrick Kane couldn't get a good handle on that.
Boy, Brian, he hasn't made many mistakes in this series, has he? What a dominant player Drew Doughty has been.
Shaw and Carter to the right of Quick. Kane with the puck. Shot by Oduya, deflected wide to the left. Now Shaw. Carter plays the puck. Tied up by Saad. Patrick Kane sends it behind the net. Muzzin is on the fair. Oduya moving in from the point. Off the stick of Saad to Kane. Patrick Kane. Payne with a shot. And that's blocked away through a screen by Quick, with Shaw setting the screen in front. And this will be an icing call against the Kings.
Well, you talk about an opportunity now. Long shift. Doughty's been out there a long time. And they have to stay on the ice.
This time, Carter does a really good job on Kane. They want to go inside out on him. See how Carter is not going to let him loop into the middle. Sure, go ahead. Double back. Stay on the wall. We'll keep you there. But we're not letting you in the middle. That's what Daryl Sutter's been preaching against Patrick Kane.
Fans recognize the opportunity here.
Patrick Kane stays on the ice. Hontschus and Versteeg off the bench. Patrick Kane with two overtime goals this year, including a series clincher against Minnesota.
Versteeg has only had one shift in the third period of just 28 seconds.
Thought he was a scratch in game six. Doughty with the puck. Up the boards for Richards. Deflects it out. Now Jeff Carter back to Drew Doughty. We played 5 minutes in overtime. Tied at four. Game seven, Western Conference Final. Buzzin, Pearson deflects it along. Seabrook back for Chicago. And now Hontschus has scored the double overtime winner in game five to keep the Blackhawks alive in this series. Seabrook up the left wing for Steve, sends in. Buck Harris off the right side of the goal, and Matt Green plays it for Los Angeles. Here's Justin Williams. Williams moves it into the corner. Redding lost his stick. Puck comes out to Martinez. Martinez with a shot. It's in! The Kings are headed to the Stanley Cup Final. The shot by Martinez deflected. It beats Crawford. It will be the Los Angeles Kings and the New York Rangers. Game one, Wednesday night at Staples Center.
The LA Kings were able to get the puck in quickly. Justin Williams led the way on the forecheck. They're able to get it free and get it back to the point. And just a simple wrist shot that hit Nick Leddy of the Chicago Blackhawks and deflected in. The resolve of the LA Kings, we've talked about them so often. They trailed 2-0. Then 3-2, 4-3 in the third before scoring late.
They're checking this, too. They're just, it's a good goal. They now officially have signaled a goal. Yep.
So the Los Angeles Kings become the first team in NHL history to win three game sevens on the road in one season.
Incredible. Again, the LA Kings are able to get the puck in. That's Justin Williams. He puts it in. He doesn't stop. He gets in, helps out, and eventually gets the puck back to the point. And here's the wrist shot. It goes off number eight, Nick Leddy, who hadn't played much in the third period. But the work by Williams to get in, get the puck, and set it up, and get everybody going to the net. Crawford didn't have a chance. And the Los Angeles Kings move on. Jonathan Quick remains perfect in game sevens. So much respect these two teams have for one another. This was just a hard-fought, clean series throughout. Bounces, and that man, number eight in white, was the best player in the series. Patrick Kane had one assist in the first four games, and then he came alive with brilliant performances in games five and six.
Olympic teammates, Kane and Quick. So the Detroit Red Wings, 97-98, remain the last team to win back-to-back Stanley Cups. The LA Kings headed back to the Stanley Cup Final for the second time in 3 years. Alec Martinez is with Brian Engblom.
Alec, what did you see? Did you know the puck went into the net when you shot it?
No, I didn't really know until Stoley started going nuts there. And it was a great play by Williams. He got up to me, and I just tried to change angle, get on net, and Stoley had a great net presence, and fortunately went in.
You guys came from behind three times in this game. What is it about this team that you can keep coming back? Nothing ever seems to bother you guys.
Yeah, I don't really know. I think it's just a testament to the character of this team, and you know, we never say die. I think someone just described us as a bunch of cockroaches. We just don't go away. So, I don't know if that's our MO. That's fine with me.
I know you're really tough on yourself after the last game when you thought you should have scored a wraparound goal that would have made the difference. How does this make up for it?
This is pretty good. Obviously, I would have liked to do it a couple days ago, but it is an awesome feeling. I'm so proud of these guys.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
The Los Angeles Kings defeat the defending Stanley Cup champion Chicago Blackhawks in overtime. Tyler Toffoli credited with the deflection on the shot from Martinez.
And then, as you can see, it also hit the Chicago player in front. The reaction of the LA Kings, a team that just never stops. They never lose their confidence. And Jonathan Toews, difficult night for him. They got it all the way back to a Game 7. Two great, great hockey teams. And the LA Kings find a way, overtime of Game 7, to get back to the Stanley Cup Final.
Ladies and gentlemen, NHL Deputy Commissioner Bill Daly will now present the Clarence Campbell Bowl to the Western Conference champion Los Angeles Kings. Accepting the trophy is team captain Dustin Brown.
Dustin Brown has done this before.
A longtime captain of the LA Kings. Last year, he had a poor playoff. He was so hurt, bad knee, couldn't skate. This year, much more effective. Four shots in the first period. Looks like a different player than he did a year ago.
How about Justin Williams? Another point in a Game 7. That sets a new NHL record, surpassing Doug Gilmour. Martinez sent the puck out, or got the puck from Williams in the corner. Watch Toffoli in front, bottom of the circle.
There it is. Oh, he gets his stick on it. Then it goes off of Nick Leddy's shoulder. And the goaltender, Corey Crawford, didn't have a chance. 73, watch the stick. We talked about his hands. Beautiful redirection off Nick Leddy, over the shoulder of Corey Crawford. And there is your game and series winner.
Second of the game for Toffoli. He tied the game at three earlier. His fifth goal of the series. For the first time since the Yankees and Dodgers in 1981, a New York-Los Angeles final. So it's the Kings and the Rangers, game one on Wednesday. Thanks for watching the Stanley Cup Playoffs presented by GEICO. For Brian Engblom and Joe Micheletti, this is Kenny Albert saying so long. Studio show up next.